Let the words of my mouth and meditation of my heart be always acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. What do you need to let go, to relinquish, to allow God fully to enter? That's the main point that Jesus is making in today's gospel. Now, if you paid any attention at all to the reading just now, this is not, on the surface, the most inviting of gospel stories. It's one of those occasions I wish Jesus would say or do different things than he says and does. It's sometimes called one of the hard sayings of Jesus. Millstones around one's neck cast into the sea, unquenchable flames of hell cutting off your hands or feet or tearing out your eyes. This is a good example of not taking all the Bible literally, or we will miss a valuable truth. There's a great deal to be revealed if we will just look below the surface. The story and those around it are about what it means to live in the kingdom of God. And the word we translate as kingdom in Greek is basileus, which can mean also the reign or the realm of God. The kingdom or the reign of God is this world and you transformed to be how God created you, how God made you to be. Now, this is not exactly true, but to help think of this in a new way, you could also translate the word kingdom as masterpiece, as in a work of art. This world, this kingdom, this masterpiece can be revealed here and now through you by removing any stumbling block that prevents its creation. Now, that's not, as we all know, how we normally think about a life of faith. Our culture reinforces the idea that to improve, we must always add something. Take a course, learn a new technique or an insight, or change your attitude. And we often unconsciously think of religion in a similar way, as something added on to the top rather than something that immersed and is all throughout ourselves. We may not be called to add one more thing, but to let some things go. The truth is that God loves each of us exactly as we are. But because of the depth of that infinite love, the Lord calls us to do something, to become a master work, a holy kingdom within you. And to discover it, we have to relinquish all those things that are not of God. Letting go of something that we've been clinging to, or letting go of something that has been holding us down or dragging us down. Letting go of all that is much harder than adding anything new. And Jesus is very direct in how he expresses this. If your hand or foot causes you to stumble, cut it off. If your eye causes you to stumble, tear it out. It's better to enter this kingdom, this realm of God, lame or blind than not at all, as he puts it for emphasis on the unquenchable flames of hell. And like any good preacher, a rabbi, or any good southern storyteller, of course Jesus used hyperbole for emphasis to make a point. This is not, of course, intended literally, but does make the point abundantly clear. Whatever keeps you from knowing God or growing closer, Jesus says, let it go. What might this mean for us? Let me come at it indirectly, and some of you helpfully know this story. In the year 1501, Michelangelo won a contract from the cathedral in Florence to create what we now call the Statue of David. And it was to be one of a series of 12 Old Testament figures. And he created it from a single block of marble that had sat outside exposed in the workshop for 25 years. The stone had been carved by two people, at least two other artists already, but they never finished the project. And over three painstaking years of working on the neglected and flawed piece of stone, he created a masterpiece. To the master, the whole concept of art was not adding anything. To sculpt meant to take away, to remove whatever did not need to be there. The sculpture already existed within it. He had to cut away the excess to allow the beauty within to emerge. The artist who created Calvary Church, Ralph Adams Cram, the architect, Johann Kirchmeier, the primary carver, and the massive team of people, they did a similar thing here at Calvary Church. They made a prayer, a work of art in stone and wood and glass. If you look all around you very closely, you'll notice things that are not obvious, and that is everything is carved not just up front, what you can see, but even up here on the pulpit. Every single surface is carved front and back and behind. The finials there in the choir stalls, up front, and you only see it if you put flowers on the altar for Christmas or Easter. It's even carved behind. Every part matters to the artist. And every splinter of wood that did not need to be there was cut, filed, sanded away. It's like pruning a tree or a plant to allow it to grow into its fullness. So if your hand or foot causes you to stumble, cut it off and leap into the kingdom. And if your eye causes you to stumble, tear it out and truly see the new world, the new realm that God has created and is creating within you. If you remember nothing else from the sermon, perhaps you can begin to think of God in a different way, not as some old man on a celestial throne, not as some impersonal cosmic force, certainly not as a justification for whatever action we want to take, but God as the creator, the sculptor, making us into the divine image. And so he asks you, God asks you, what are the stumbling blocks in your life that inhibit that creation? What do you need to allow God to chisel away? Someone said to me earlier, could the Lord start with a few pounds I picked up during the pandemic? Maybe so. What about that tightness between my shoulders? What about the stress that seems to come at me from every single direction? We might consider that all those are simply symptoms. But Jesus calls us to look for the root cause, to look always beneath the surface. Is it possibly pride or anger or vanity? Is it maybe the games that we sometimes play, the image we try to project to the world we so desperately want others to think about us, trying to be in control, our false sense of security in money and things or status, or the fear or regret that clings to us, the need to blame outwardly rather than look inwardly? What inhibits your full creation? They're all stumbling blocks to the life that God intends for each of us, and they hide that Christ waiting to emerge. What would God find inside of you if all that were taken away? What do you see when you stand by yourself in front of the mirror? Everyone that God has made, everyone whom God has made, is loved and valued from brokenness, from wholeness, to a speck of dust or a block of stone into a work of art. And God is the artist. You are the masterpiece, but an unfinished one. Our Lord always sees the good, the perfect work that is emerging from within you. What you need to let go, to allow God to reveal the kingdom through you.